Section 302. Kunti said, according to thy promise, I will, O king, with concentrated mind, serve thy Brahmana, O foremost of kings. I do not say this falsely. It is my nature to worship Brahmanas, and as in the present case, my doing so would be agreeable to thee. Even this would be highly conducive to my welfare. Whether that worshipful one cometh in the evening or in morning, or at night, or even at midnight, he will have no reason to be angry with me, O foremost of kings. To do good by serving the twice-born ones, observing all thy commands, is what I consider to be highly profitable to me, O best of men. Do thou, therefore, O foremost of monarchs, rely on me, that best of Brahmanas, while residing in thy house, shall never have cause for dissatisfaction. I tell thee truly, I shall, O king, be always attentive to that which is agreeable to this Brahmana, and what is fraught also with good to thee, O sinless one. I know full well that Brahmanas that are eminently virtuous, when propitiated, bestow salvation, and when displeased, are capable of bringing about destruction upon the offender. Therefore, I shall please this foremost of Brahmanas. Thou will not, O monarch, come to any grief from that best of regenerate persons, owing to any act of mine, in consequence of transgression of monarchs. Brahmanas, O foremost of kings, became the cause of evil to them, as Chavana had become in consequence of the act of Sukanya. I will therefore, O king, with great regularity, wait upon that best of Brahmanas, according to thy instructions in that respect. And when she had thus spoken at length, the king embraced and cheered her, and instructed her in detail as to what should be done by her. And the king said, Thou shalt, O gentle maid, act even thus, without fear, for my good as also thy own, and for the good of thy race also. For thou hast faultless limbs. And having said this, the illustrious Kunti Bhoja, who was devoted to the Brahmanas, made over the girl Pritha to that Brahmana, saying, This is my daughter, O Brahmana, is of tender age, and brought up in luxury. If therefore she transgresses at any time, do thou not take that to heart. Illustrious Brahmanas are never angry with old men, children, and ascetics, even if these transgress frequently. In respect of even a great wrong, forgiveness is due from the regenerate. The worship, therefore, O best of Brahmanas, that is offered to the best of the one's power and exertion, should be acceptable. Hearing these words of the monarch, the Brahmana said, So be it. Thereupon the king became highly pleased, and assigned unto him apartments that were white as swans or the beams of the moon. And in the room intended for the sacrificial fire, the king placed a brilliant seat especially constructed for him. And the food and other things that were offered unto the Brahmana were of the same excellent kind. And casting aside idleness and all sense of self-importance, the princess addressed herself with right good will to wait upon the Brahmana. And the chaste Kunti, endued with the purity of conduct, went thither for serving the Brahmana, and duly waiting upon that Brahmana as if he were a very god, she gratified him highly. Thus ended section 302 in the Kundala Harana Parva of the Vana Parva.